Welcome to aircraft production planning. We're going to talk in this module about managing competencies. And what do we mean by competence? Well, there's a range of expressions that we can use here to understand exactly what we mean by competence. And first of all, let's talk about unconscious competence. We have the individual neither understands nor knows how to do something, nor recognizes the deficit, nor has a desire to address it. Unconscious incompetence is quite dangerous, particularly around aeroplanes. People can hurt themselves, people can damage aeroplanes, people can behave in a way that really, really causes us problems. So unconscious incompetence is very bad news. Do we have unconscious incompetence in the workplace? Of course we do. We were talking about the guy who was paint stripping the belly of the aeroplane. He was given a piece of Tufnell scraper and he thought, this is rubbish, I can do a lot better than this. And he wanders over to the scrap bin and got a piece of metal. He had no idea what he was doing. This guy was unconsciously incompetent. So it's not necessarily that people do something with a desire to have a harmful outcome, not at all. He simply didn't know. So the organization has to manage people, particularly where we have the potential of unconscious incompetence. And when we bring people into the environment, we are, as the managers, if you like, as the organization, we are responsible for these people. I want you to imagine, for example, in the UAE, where they bring people from so many different countries. In fact, Emirates have people that speak 70 different languages in the organization. 70 languages. Other companies that operate MROs, for example, they will bring people from different countries. And depending on your particular skill set, maybe you will find people from a particular country. So it's quite possible, for example, to find cleaners that have come from Bangladesh or Pakistan. And these guys are cleaners in the hangar. Do they know English? No. Their team leader knows a little bit of English. And you say to him, can you ask your guys to go and clean in the undercarriage compartment? Yes, boss. Is it okay? Yes, boss. He doesn't know what the undercarriage compartment is. But he won't say to you, can you show me? He'll just say, yes, boss. And then he'll go off and speak to his cleaners in Bangladeshi and say, we've got to do something, but I don't really know what we've got to do. Yeah, but you're supposed to be our communicator. He says, yeah, I know. And so on and so on. So we've got to manage it in a particular way. And we've got to understand the challenges and we've got to deal with it. Then we have this one. This is a different story. Conscious incompetence. This is okay. I am a consciously incompetent pilot. What does it mean? It means I'm not going to fly an airplane because I can't fly airplanes. I'm not a pilot. I'm an engineer. And so I'm consciously incompetent. But that's okay because I know it. I'm not going to cause a problem. So that level brings a whole different set of situations. Could I change an engine on this aeroplane, on a 777? Well, yes, I could. I've never done one in my life, but I know I can do it. I also know it's going to take a long time, because even before I go near the aeroplane, I will be in the books, I'll be talking to people, and so on, and so on, and so on. So it will be done in a step-by-step process, and will take a long time. And there's something in this story here, because in the workplace, the more competent people are, the more they're able to deliver in an effective way. The less competent they are, or the less knowledge they have of the specific requirements, the longer it's going to take. So spending time managing, communicating, being effective with our oversight processes pays dividends. And often, organizations disconnect from this. For example, you get skill dilution. you get the best guys leave. And it's normal. You go to an organization, you learn, you develop, and unless that organization is feeding your soul, you go somewhere else. And so you find, after a period of time, that your skill level in certain areas is desperate. The guys that over-talked or under-talked the wheels on the airplane, which I'll have a read when we stop, see what I can find out about it. But there's a case in point. You know, you are not going to deliberately do something and somebody says, do you realise in about 2 weeks' time these wheels are going to fall off? We don't. He thought probably what he was doing was absolutely correct.